Όπως το είπαμε λοιπόν, πετύχαμε το φιλοράκο μας 2 ώρες πριν. Δεν είχαμε άλλη δυνατότητα για να γίνει αυτή τη στιγμή live, αλλά μικρό το κακό. Με μία Jose Cuervo δίπλα μας, η κουβέντα ξεκίνησε έτσι ακριβώς. So, hi Ivalo.
Hi.
What do we find you in this particular moment?
What am I doing?
Yes.
Well, I'm sitting in a hotel room. And I've been doing some phoners for you Greek people.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I've been up to, and that's what I'm doing at the moment. We're in Cologne at the moment. We've started our German tour like 1.5 weeks ago, and starting to get into the mood. This is an off day, taking it easy today.
Is it true that you are on tour with a Mission?
Yeah, Mission are like a very special guest on tour. A cool band. It was a really nice thing for to be able to create such a situation, because they recorded their new album and stuff like that, so they had the time to, and they had the reasons come over, so it's beautiful.
Nice. The only thing that I'm wondering, you're supposed to be here in the early days of September, thinking that it never happened. What is really
something changed? I don't have a clue.
You don't have?
No, I don't have a clue. Are you talking about that? I was supposed to be there for our promotion.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what happened. You know, the dates are changing all the time, you know. But one thing I know for sure, that we're coming over to Greece to play a couple of gigs soon as well, so...
Hopefully.
Hopefully that's not going to change.
Let's focus on your brand new album, Deep Shadows and Bring Iron Highlights.
Yeah.
Do you think that it's go a little further than your steps in love songs and in Razorblade romance?
Well, I think that we're sort of taking like baby steps, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's the first album and the second album, they're a bit different, but not that different. But I'd say with the new album, it's the same thing, you know. Of course, you can't do the same album twice, so it's sort of a natural evolution or whatever you want to call it, you know. So this is a bit more melodic and a bit more straightforward this time around, but you never know what's going to happen next.
Cool. What's really for you Deep Shadows and Brilliant Highlights? I mean, this is a big contrast between black and white.
Well,
right.
You know, that's, hopefully we have that contrast in our music, you know, that there's moments of joy and moments of sadness and everything in between, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing, we've always had that contrast in the record titles, you know, Razorblade and Romance and Greatest Love Songs Volume 666. So we've always had that black and white, that yin and yang in the album titles. So basically this is just following the same path.
Για εκείνους που δεν κατάλαβαν, και εμείς το ψάχναμε, χαμογελάω και απλώς και μόνο. Βρίσκονται λοιπόν σε περιοδία μαζί με τους Mission, βρίσκονται στη Γερμανία. Από εκεί ξεκινάει άλλωστε η ευρωπαϊκή τους τουρνέ. Ή αν καταλάβαμε καλά, και σωστά καταλάβαμε, για τη Γερμανία. Έχουν ετοιμάσει ήδη καινούργια δουλειά. Βεβαίως είναι πάρα πολύ ευχαριστημένοι. Και από ό,τι έχουμε μάθει, πολύ ευτυχισμένοι που βρίσκονται από δίπλα τους οι Mission, οι οποίοι επίσης έχουν καινούργια δουλειά. Όσο για την καινούργια τους δουλειά, πιστεύουν ότι μπορεί να έχουν κάνει ένα ακόμα βήμα, αλλά το βήμα είναι μικρό. Δεν μπορούν άλλωστε να κάνουν το ίδιο που κάναν με το Razorblade. Αυτά πολύ εν ολίγης. Να δούμε και τη συνέχεια. I've heard and I've seen that the big names producing and cooperating in your record, like Kevin Shirley, John Frigory, even in the mixing, are big names like Randy Staub and Chris Lord Alge, if I'm right.
Yeah. Well, it's just basically we had a lot of time, you know. We were in a hurry in that sense, so we just called some people up and asked what they're doing, and some of them had the time to experiment on the thing. It's just like, it was pretty simple. We started off with a Finnish guy called TT, and we basically finished the album with him, and then on a couple of tracks we just needed some advice, so we flew Kevin over to Finland, and he helped us out on a couple of tracks, and that was about it. It was really simple in that sense. No huge fights in the studio or anything like that.
Could we say that a few of your tracks can be favored, like people say, in joy and sorrow?
Well, in joy and sorrow, at least that's one of my favorite tracks on the album.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, girl, we are the same. We are young and lost and so afraid. There's no cure for the pain, no shelter from the rain.
Ακούγοντας το αγαπημένο θέμα του Valo, In Joy and Sorrow. Λέγοντας ορισμένες κουβεντούλες για τους ανθρώπους οι οποίοι συμμετείχαν σε αυτή τη δουλειά, που όπως ο ίδιος είπε, είχαν όλο τον χρόνο δικό τους. Ανθρώπους όπως ο Kevin Sear λέει, αυτό το όνομα θα λέει πάρα πολλά για τους Έρους με τους Bon Jovi, με τους οποίους έχουν συνεργαστεί. Έχει συνεργαστεί. Αλλά και τον Fryer. Φέρνοντας το βάρος των Nine Inch Nails αλλά και τον White Zombie, ως και τα επόμενα δύο ονόματα που ακούστηκαν, δηλαδή του Stoud και του Alge, για τα remix. Από τους μετάλλικα του Bon Jovi και τον Bon Jovi, στη Τίνα Τάρνερ και στον Keith Richard. Καταλαβαίνετε λοιπόν το μεγαλείο των ονομάτων όταν βρίσκονται πίσω από την παραγωγή, παρέα βεβαίως πάντα με τους ίδιους του σχήμα. Συνέχεια λοιπόν από τις κουβέντες, βάλω η συνέχεια. What else? I was wondering how things are in Germany now with all this mess around the world. The audience following the music, how is it?
Well, it's basically the same, you know. I said the music anyway, it's music is a tool, a way of escaping the ordinary life for us, you know, especially gigs, you know, for that 1.5 hours or whatever, you know. It's an important thing, you know. It's the mess has always been there. It's just for the first time, because something like that happened in America, people are turning their faces towards it and being so sorry for everything and blah blah blah. But there's so many people who don't understand that wars and terrorist attacks, they're going on everywhere in the world, and they've been going on for years and years. But it's just like the poor countries, you know, nobody takes care of the poor countries, and nobody's interested in what's going on in there. So it's pretty sad, actually, that it took such a huge event to happen before people understood that there are sad things going on in the world, you know, and there's been sad things going on in the world for a long time.
If people say that something really happened in that night in 11 September, the world is not anymore the same, do you think that's going to affect in music, musicians?
No, it's not going to affect musicians. Well, probably it affects the musicians who live in Manhattan or whatever, you know, but it's... those sorts of things that's been happening all the time, you know. Mm-hmm. There's bomb threats all the time. There's bombs exploding everywhere in Spain, for example.
Mm-hmm.
All the time and stuff like that, which is really, really a like pitiful thing. I'm sorry that all that
Δεν μπορούσαμε βέβαια να αποφύγουμε τη συγκεκριμένη ερώτηση για το πώς είναι τα πράγματα στη Γερμανία, πώς ο κόσμος ακολουθά τις συναυλίες και τις μουσικές. Όπως λοιπόν ο ίδιος ο Βάλο θεωρεί, ο κόσμος χρειάζεται να την κοπανάει από την καθημερινότητα και σίγουρα η μουσική έχει τον πρώτο ρόλο, πόσο μάλλον οι συναυλίες και τα gigs. Από την άλλη μεριά θεώρησε ότι η τρομοκρατία υπάρχει παντού και πάντα, σε όλη τη γη, και αυτό που έγινε στην Αμερική ήταν απλώς ένα γεγονός που έκανε τη διαφορά, αλλά και κάποιους ανθρώπους να συνειδητοποιήσουν ότι και πέρα από την Αμερική συμβαίνουν καθημερινά, όπως υπάρχει η φτώχεια, υπάρχει από δίπλα η τρομοκρατία. Καταλαβαίνετε. Yes, Philippe, I don't know, I can talk about my country, perhaps I think that a thing affects the people from the one way or the other, and something weird is in the atmosphere, in the air, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
At least for those first days, we'll see what can happen in future. Let's go back in music. I'm sure that you're happy with the result of Deep Shadows and Brilliant Highlights.
Yeah, I was pretty happy with it. Yeah.
You're feeling that your next step is going to be like, I know it's quite early, but do you think that you can see what is going to be the new thing?
Well, we have a couple of ideas and a couple of new songs written already for the
album. Coming, but, you know?
Let's see what's going to happen with it. You know, things change so much. It's definitely going to be a bit different, but it's a secret. I won't tell you yet.
But it's going to be in the steps of that we call love metal.
Well, yeah, it's still going to be sentimental and it's still going to be emotional, that's for sure. But you know, let's see. From what sort of an angle we're going to approach the same topic, you know, next time around.
So hopefully we'll see you in the first days of December, just before Christmas, right?
Yeah, we're coming.
And this is a promise.
Yeah, it is a promise. Yeah,
all right. Thank you. It's nice to talk with you, Valo.
Nice
see
to
us
talk with you
in a few months.
Yeah, see you soon.
Thank you very
all
much.
Right, take care.
Ciao.
Bye.
Αυτή ήταν λοιπόν η κουβεντούλα. Μια κουβεντούλα ανάμεσα σε προβλήματα, τηλεφωνικά. Προβλήματα που υπάρχουν γύρω μας, δυστυχώς. Αλλά και μουσικές που υπάρχουν να μας βοηθάνε να βλέπουμε και τον κόσμο με άλλο μάτι. Οι μουσικές λοιπόν των Χήμα και το αποτέλεσμα της τρεις γραφής δουλειάς τους φέρνει το Βάλο σίγουρα ευχαριστημένο, όπως ο ίδιος δηλώνει. Έχουν έτοιμο κάτι στα σκαριά, ήδη υπάρχουν κανένα δύο tracks. Δεν ήθελε να μας πει παραπάνω πράγματα και αν τα θεωρεί και είναι έκπληξη. Η υπόσχεση από τον ίδιο και τη μεριά του, μεριά των Χίμ, ότι το πρώτο δεκαήμερο του Δεκεμβρίου θα είναι εδώ. Για όλα τα υπόλοιπα και από όσο γνωρίζουμε, οι drag που ακούμε τώρα θα είναι από δίπλα.